800. This will be a great race. Oh, Gray got left. Rodal away well. Gray's going to have to work hard. Lahlou, Téllez out hard of Cuba. Kiptoo, one of two Kenyans. Sepeng, South Africa. Onyancha, the other Kenyan, and Motchebon. Gray has to lead. It's the way he goes. He was 7th in 84. He was 5th in 88 and 3rd in 92. He leads them out. Rodal is in second. And moving up hard is Kiptoo and also Onyancha. And just behind them, Sepeng.
Now, it's going to be a tremendous race between the Kenyans. There's two of them in this race. And they know that Gray's going to go out hard. The big thing is whether they're going to try to upset it or whether they're just going to tuck in and try to run over the top of him down the back straight.
Onyancha second at the moment and Kiptoo third. Gray leading them out. This is going to be a fast first lap. Fourth Rodal, fifth Téllez. There's Johnny Gray, the veteran. 36 years of age, 49-55 the split. He stretches away now. Onyancha and Kiptoo behind him. And also Lahlou of Morocco improving quickly. Next is Rodal, Motchebon. Téllez starting to improve and Sepeng is back to last.
I think Kiptoo's out of it. He's going back. Motchebon on the outside there. Look at the strength of this man, which he's going to need every ounce of it to close the gap over the last 150, 200 metres.
Kiptoo trying to get through, got cut off by Onyancha. And it looks like Rodal to challenge Gray with 150 to run. Téllez late, Kiptoo around them. Sepeng will be very late. A great finish coming up. Rodal goes up, joins Gray, takes him. Kiptoo, watch for Sepeng, very late with Téllez. Rodal clear for Norway though, holds them at bay. Sepeng can't get to him with Kiptoo and Téllez. Rodal stopping, hanging on, gets there. Fabulous time, breaking the Olympic record. 142.59.
What a sensational race. We had our doubts about Rodal coming into the final. He didn't look quite so good in the semi-final. He only qualified as one of the fastest non-automatic qualifiers, but he can't believe it. He's absolutely ecstatic, collapsed prone on the track.
Well, Johnny Gray made the running. He missed the start, I felt. He got caught a little, just a metre or so, and then chased very hard and set up a fast race. Four Olympic finals and just one bronze. But Rodal, the 23-year-old from Norway, third last year in the World Championships, has run one of the fast times, 142.59. That's, in fact, down to 142.58. That would be the fastest championship time ever.
Well, he came into the Olympics with the second fastest time this year. He's really lived up to that sort of form. He's the Norwegian 400 and 800 metre champion and national record holder. We saw a little bit of that 400 metre speed over that last 200, an unbelievable finish.
So look at the times, 142.58 for Rodal, Sepeng second, 142.74. There's some major breakthroughs here. Third on Ancha in 142.79. Fourth Téllez, 142.85, and fifth Motchebon in 143.91. Just fantastic times, and national records and personal best. There's Sepeng of South Africa. He's amongst the medals, getting the silver. Just fabulous riding. Kiptoo, 144.19. What a great final, Deke. Gray sets them up, doesn't he, with his fast times. He's been doing this for 12 years now.
And it's really one of the first Olympics and the first World Championship events that we've seen where the Kenyans haven't been able to take it out. And it's wonderful to see a Norwegian, a relatively small country, but obviously with a tremendous history in distance running with the great Ingrid Christensen and Greta Waitz. And here we have him crossing the finish line well and truly clear.
And a Sepeng and Onyancha hanging on, and Téllez. Look, Téllez has done brilliantly. Here was the battle up the straight. Johnny Gray's finished seventh, just as he did 12 years ago in Los Angeles.
And the strength in Rodal, finishing on, lifting his knees, driving his arms all the way right down. Tremendous race there for second, third and fourth.
It was the most exciting final, wasn't it? I mean, it had the crowd on their feet here with the American leading out. And here's Gray, Rodal. Kiptoo had no luck at all. He kept getting cut off. He was moved up to third. Onyancha behind him. Téllez straining. And now Sepeng moves out to make his late move. He lost a bit of ground there.
And the acceleration that Rodal has, he's there still as they come now into the straight. with only 100 metres to go. He's right there, shoulder to shoulder. And with 80 metres, in about 20 metres, he opens up a 2-metre lead on the rest of the field when they're all accelerating as well. A tremendous turn of pace.
So a magic moment here for Rodal of Norway, and it hasn't been the only magic we've seen tonight.
Olympic magic.